Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Kuji once again. So this video right here, I'm going to be talking about MTV's hottest MCs in the game in 2010. And I will tell you guys the list. If you guys didn't watch it, you know, I'll let you guys know who was the hot MCs in the game. No, you let me know what your thoughts are. You know, the funny thing is that if you guys didn't look at my last video that I talked about the hottest MCs in the game last year, I was wearing the same shirt. The same shirt. Just want to bring that out to y'all. Alright, so here it goes. So, start from number 10 to number 1. Alright, to number 10, you had Ludacris. Number 9, you had B.O.B. Number 8, you had Waka Flocka Flame. Number 7, you had Lil Wayne. Number 6, you had Nicki Minaj. Number 5, you had Rick Ross. Number 4, you had Drake. Number 3, you had Kanye West. Number 2, you had Jay-Z. And number 1, the hottest MC in the game in 2010 is Eminem. So, there you have it. Now, my thoughts about this, I have to say that there's some things I would say that I do agree, some things I don't agree. I mean, of course, you know, some people, you know, get pissed off when, you know, they see that rappers that they don't like and they see them on the list. But at the same time, the list says MTV's hottest MCs in the game. That's all it says. It doesn't say MTV's best MCs in the game or MTV's most lyrical MCs in the game. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's all about who's hot, basically. It's all about who's hot. Like I said in my last video, was that I'm not going to do like the same crap that I did. But it is what it is, all right? It's all about who's hot, and that's what it's all about. But still, some of those people who does MTV anyway don't even know what they're talking about. So I'll just let you know my thoughts. For Ludacris to be on number 10, I would say, should he really be number 10? You know what I mean? Ludacris, I mean, he had a good year. You know, he did all right, everything, you know. But still, you know, he came back because I was like, when is Ludacris going to drop an album? Not drop an album, but like, Ludacris hasn't really done much, but, you know, it's like Ludacris is just here and there. You know, he probably make an album out, come out with an album like 2008. He did, but then it's like, where is Ludacris? Like, you know, where is he? But then he made it, you know. I will say, you know, yeah, it's better than others, so it's like, oh, it's all right. For B.O.B., number 9, you know, when I first heard B.O.B., you know, well, for him to make it hot MC, I do congratulate him to actually make it. But still, for when I first heard him, I know he had a song, you know, Haters Everywhere We Go, Haters Everywhere We Go. Rich Boy was on that too. And when B.O.B. was in this, was first coming in the rap game, I was like, he's probably going to be another hype rapper and just do nothing. But when I heard Airplanes, when I first heard Airplanes, that actually touched me. Like, really, that was like, wow. And until, like, and when I heard the part two, I was like, wow. Man. It really did touch me, though. Like, Airplanes really did touch me. Like, I really like Airplanes. I mean, it's not like a classic or anything, but it's still, it really let me think about it. Yeah, but still. Yeah, it was really good. So congratulations to B.O.B. to actually make it. Number 8 for Waka Flocka. I guess, yeah, he's hot. I was actually surprised that Waka Flocka made it, but Gucci Mane didn't make it. But who cares about Gucci Mane? Gucci Mane didn't even do anything anyway. But it's like Gucci Mane helped Waka Flocka. And think about this. The only reason why Waka Flocka is even in the rap game is because his mother knows this one producer. Like, she knows about producers. And that's how Waka Flocka even got a record deal. He probably met Gucci Mane and all that stuff, and Gucci Mane wanted to call him Waka Flocka. Which is stupid. It's like, why you call your own son Waka Flocka? I don't know. But yeah, you know, he's hot this year, but I don't know about him being in the top 10, but I don't really care. Waka Flocka Flame ain't nothing anyway. Walk a Flock. All right, number seven, Lil Wayne in the Lil Wayne number seven. you know the funny thing is that ever since 2008, you know he hasn't really done. He really has like improved himself to actually be like he's number one. I mean, like, I'm talking about, like, in the list, you know what I'm saying? But overall, like, as a, like, the years that he's been doing, like, when you look at Lil Wayne, what do you look at him? You know, he's just a rapper. You know, like, it's Lil Wayne the rapper. You know, you don't think more of that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's like the only reason why he's a millionaire is because he makes songs. That's why he got all these mixtapes and he's featured on other songs because he's trying to make that money. And that's it. You know, that's all Lil Wayne is. And to see Lil Wayne like that is like, you know. You know, Lil Wayne, he's not like Jay-Z. Lil Wayne's not gonna be like no businessman. he's gonna look so ugly when he's like in his like 60s and he's gonna have all those tattoos. Alright, next, number six, Nicki Minaj. Now, to see Nicki Minaj on here, I would say, you know, for Nicki Minaj and Drake, you know, being hotter than Lil Wayne, it's like, wow. But everybody knows is that, okay, everybody knows this is true. If Drake and Nicki Minaj was not with Lil Wayne, they would not be hot. And no one can't deny that. I mean, that's the only reason why Nicki Minaj and Drake are even hot in the first place. I mean, yeah, true. Drake, who's number four, good year too. He really would not be where he's at right now. If he was like in another record label, like just random, you know, where would Drake be right now? Drake is lucky that he's there. And especially, you know, in his rookie year, I would say. Well, I should say in his rookie year, you know, well, starting as solo and all stuff, he's really lucky that Drake, that he's really getting what he's got right now. But at the same time, I have seen this before. I've seen a lot of rappers that who do really good in their first album, who, you know, who are hot, and then somehow, you know, it's either like this. After the first album is done, no one doesn't care about them, or they'll make two or three more albums and no one else doesn't talk about them anymore. But we'll see how Drake goes in the next 5 years, you know. We'll see. Canadians. But like I said, Nicki Minaj, you know, Nicki Minaj, I know people are giving her credit and everything, you know, they're giving her credit saying like, you know, oh, she's really talented, you know, she's doing her thing. Let me get this straight. Many people like her, especially the girls. Many girls like her because she's a woman. And that's pretty much it. I mean, really? I mean, come on. How many female rappers are even in the rap game? Not better yet. How many female rappers are still in the rap game that people even give a damn about? Not really. Not much. I mean, when you think of the past of female rappers, you know, it's like, who cares? Like, who cares right now? And, what else? And then, next you had Rick Ross, who was a number five, you know. Who cares? Kanye West, number three. Didn't really do much, but, you know. But did Power. Oh. Hey. Oh, okay. And then number two, like I said, Jay-Z, Eminem. I can't deny that Eminem is hotter than Jay-Z, like, this year. I mean, no one can deny that Eminem had a better year this year, you know, but still, like, MC, you know, Jay-Z, Eminem, you know, Jay-Z, Eminem are one of the best MCs in the game, you know. I don't care what anybody says, you know, about Jay-Z worships the devil and all that stuff, but they have no proof that Jay-Z worships the devil, you know, no matter what. I mean, before all this happened, before everybody was thinking about that, Everybody was saying how much Jay-Z was the best. But now everybody wants to betray him, you know. I don't know why. But that's what y'all gotta say, you know. There you go, top 10 list. Make sure you check out the Sports for Today show. Contact me, you know it is. Alright, peace.